Hey everyone, welcome back to more One Night in Karazhan. Last time we took on the self-proclaimed comedian, the Magic Mirror, and didn't really get to play out Yogg-Saron as much as I really wanted to, but nonetheless, we wiped the floor with him, and that fight was a lot of fun. And like I said before, deck I was using was fantastic for it. And this time, we will be taking on the chess match. Let's begin.
Medivh left the chess pieces out again. This might get tricky.
So, the chess king guards the stairs. Win a game to reach the next floor. Now, the chess match, for those of you who actually played World of Warcraft and you did the Karazhan raid, you know what that chess match is, and it was a lot of fun. The people who designed that one apparently had a hand in designing this one, or they were the ones who designed it. I don't know the specific story, but they ended up, nonetheless, having a big impact with this one. And let's see, they could cheat, destroy the leftmost enemy minion. So, they're a dirty cheater. Let's go ahead and play this one. And I do not get to pick my hero.
The White King versus the Black King.
None shall pass.
On guard.
I wonder what happens if I try to mulligan any of these. Oh, okay, I actually do get something different. This'll be fun.
Here, pieces will attack automatically at the end of your turn.
Yep. My hero power is castle. Discover a chess piece. And let's see. I can actually have emotes. Let's do it.
Care for a game? Always.
Heh.
Checkmate.
Not yet.
How very kind.
Anytime.
Ah, exceptional.
Naturally.
Oh, a blunder.
Or a trap.
I see a mate in four.
I see one in three.
Oh, those are fun. Anyways, let's go ahead and just play out my white pawn.
En passant. Job done. En passant. En passant.
Well, that's no good.
If a piece is between two enemies, it will strike them both.
En passant.
And also, as you noticed, whenever they attack at the end of the turn, the ones that attack do not take any damage. Fun times, huh?
En passant.
Proper positioning is key to victory. Get those double attacks.
Yep, proper positioning. Okay, what can I do here? That one's just 2 damage. That one's restore 2 health to adjacent minions.
Marvelous.
Let's do that just to get some health in. Okay. Yeah, because I know its hero power is destroying my leftmost minion, so I want to put him over there to the left, the pawns always. I'm actually thinking really hard about this, and while I'm thinking, I shall do this. Yeah, that never gets old. I'm getting attacked.
Oh.
I get the feeling I'm about to lose horribly in this one.
The other guests are lining up outside. We're nearly to the opera, but we need to hurry.
Marvelous.
Job's done.
Yeah, that was almost pretty much stupid. And I'm just going to discover another piece. Because we need the double attacks in here. Like that.
Checkmate.
Okay, he's got a full board again. That's bad. And here I thought I was making a comeback. Guess not. We're gonna place her right there.
Job's done.
And enter. Okay, so he's finally out of cards. And he's pretty much only got pawns for days. Ooh, another white queen. I'm gonna place her right here.
Checkmate.
Place that right there. And in turn. So he got another queen out, and that means that that queen's dead. Yeah, I get the feeling I'm going to lose quite badly. Yeah. I believe that this one is... I'm done. Yep, let's see what happens. Because either way, I'm pretty sure I am boned. Yeah, there's his charge, so he's probably going after the queen. Awesome. And we're back to this. This requires a lot of thought input, man. Holy cow. Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and kill that. I'm gonna do that and discover another piece. I'm gonna go with another horsey. Or the knight. But why is the horse called a knight? That's just silly. Okay, so another queen. And he's gonna kill off that pawn. That's fine. And still alive, baby. Still kicking.
Marvelous.
I'm just gonna put him there, because I know that one's gonna die, because of his hero power. Let's see what happens. I could have done the placement a lot better there, but I didn't. Alright, so she's back up to 4. Let's get a knight. Or get her. That'll actually work out quite well. Checkmate. And discover another one. There you are. And immature. I don't want her to die, so I'm going to play him there. Play that. Hit his bishop there. Hero power. We'll discover another queen. And enter. Yeah, we're making a comeback, baby! Here we go. Cheater. Go another white pawn who can just go right there. You are gonna die anyways, so gonna do that just to guarantee that one will die and play her right here.
Checkmate.
And just hero power because why not? I disagree with your statement, sir. There we go!
Well done. At this rate, we'll reach the top of the tower in time to save the party.
Yeah, like, in a few weeks. Okay, so we succeeded in the chess match. That was actually... That took a lot of thought input just to kind of figure out everything, and I wasn't really playing the best. Because I will admit, I kind of just woke up about 30 minutes ago. And I'm not in the best thought processing right now. But anyways, that was a lot of fun. And we made a big comeback after only being down to 2 health. But that was incredible. And for winning, we get the Ivory Knight for the Paladins. Its battle cry is you discover a spell and restore health to your hero equal to its cost. So this is just making the Paladins Helodins now. Especially since Whispers of the Old Gods included Forbidden Healing, which is incredibly amazing, and Ragnaros, Light Lord, which is also incredible. So, Paladins are becoming incredibly good healers. So, there's that. And for the Warriors, we get Protect the King, which is exactly like Unleash the Hounds, but instead of getting doggies with taunts, you get dogs with charge on that one. You get pawns with taunts. And putting this in a taunting deck is really good. And I tried making one of those before with Bolster and the King's Defender, which is the weapon that gives all of your taunting minions. Or if you have a minion with taunt, it gives you +2/+3. But with Bolster, you'll have 3/3s with taunt. And if your opponent happen to have a relatively full board, say against a Zulok, this is a good card, especially in unison with Bolster. So I look forward to seeing decks that come out. Alrighty, we have defeated the Parlor. Not saved it, we destroyed it. And for doing that, we have an Arcanosmith, or Arcanosmith. Oh. It's battle cry. Summon a 0/5 minion with taunt. That's not bad. You get a beefy taunt, and basically with the value of that, you're basically getting a 3/7 for 4. However, against priests, if they happen to have a Shadow Word Pain, they're dead anyways. And Cloaked Huntress for the Hunter. Your secrets cost 0. That is like the Kirin Tor Mage, but better. I think it's Kirin Tor Mage. I'll have to look at that, the mage card. It's the one that your next secret costs zero. But this one, all of your secrets cost zero. So that's going to change up some of the hunter decks that we've seen. Ambaros, he's a 3/1/1 stealth. At the end of your turn, summon a 1/1 steward. Once again, that might not be bad for Zulok decks, especially since he has stealth. And now we have class challenges unlocked for a shaman, if you will, and a priest, or priest, if you will.
Excellent. The opera house is just up those stairs. I'm sure Barnes will let us through quickly.
you're funny. Of course he's not. This is an adventure. So, that was the first wing of One Night in Karazhan, the parlor. First, we took on the silverware golem. That was a lot of fun. Then we took on the magic mirror. That was incredibly fun. And then we took on the chess match, which was even more fun. So, with that being said, next week, I believe as of the recording that this will be going up, which I'm trying to, week two will already be out. So, next time, we're going to start up on the opera. And I'm looking forward to that, just to see how well or how badly things will go. So, thank you all so much for watching, and you have a great day, and I'll see you next time.